feel of pressure on the regime. Assad hasn't been seen in 2 weeks, and he's giving a highly anticipated speech to the Syrian parliament. And there's an expectation that's hardened into an assumption that he's going to announce major reforms. That doesn't happen. He comes out and talks about people being duped and conspiracies. So I want, you know, David, maybe you can start by talking about the shock of that moment and its implications, what it meant both for this idea of who he was and the exercise of power in Syria.
Yeah, well, there was, during the course of my research and involved in a particular project on Syria, on which I'm working over the last 3 years, I had the opportunity to connect again with many people who were close to Assad, some of whom are still with him, others who are in exile or defected or left the government for one reason or another. And a consistent picture emerged when examining this is that there was a lot of confusion and potentially intrigue in the certainly the weeks and the days since the disturbances in Daraa and Assad's speech. And there was a lot of mystery of, you know, where he was, what was he going to do in this speech, which I think is a seminal moment in modern Middle East history. And what I learned from many of these people who were involved in the preparation for the speech is that there were many different drafts. One person who was a close friend of Assad, who's no longer in the government, he saw a draft about an hour before Bashar went to the Syrian parliament to deliver his speech. And it was full of concessions and announcements of reforms. And so when Assad gave his speech in the parliament on TV, and this guy was watching it on TV, he was shocked to see that it was another version. And in his mind, and other people who I met who were involved in that particular situation, they believe that some of the security chiefs got to Assad. And there has been a tug of war between a number of different individuals, some counseling, you know, that he make concessions, some that he crack down, and that ultimately the security chiefs convinced Assad that they could put down the uprising in a couple of weeks and then they could just go back to normal. And so he gave that speech, which, you know, reflects the fact that he's someone that a lot of people had hope for when he came into power as a reformer. And this was, in my view, this was his moment. You know, and a lot of people in Syria, opposition and pro-Assad, were waiting for this moment. Could he be the person they all thought he hoped he could be? Finally, stand up to the hardliners and do something. And obviously, he did not. And there was a great deal of disappointment, a lot of disappointment among Syrian officials and government people with whom I've spoke, not just the opposition. So I know.